Owls Do Cry was the debut novel of the New Zealand author Janet Frame. First published in 1957, it's since been hailed as a modernist masterpiece, while Frame herself was frequently praised as New Zealand's greatest ever novelist. She died in 2004 at the age of 79. She grew up in a working-class family on New Zealand's South Island, training to be a teacher when she was 19 and beginning to work in a school 2 years later. However, she suffered increasingly severe bouts of mental illness, causing her to abandon the classroom in 1945. For the next few years, she was repeatedly hospitalised and eventually diagnosed with schizophrenia, which in those days was treated with severe electric shocks. Finally, she was scheduled for a lobotomy, a surgical procedure in which significant pathways in the brain are severed, for which her mother had given permission. She had just published a collection of short stories, which was considered irrelevant. Until, that is, it won a major literary prize, whereupon the hospital superintendent was forced to backtrack and cancel her operation. In 1955, she met a fellow writer called Frank Sargerson, a mentor to a significant number of New Zealand authors, who invited her to live and work in a hut on his property, which is where she wrote Owls Do Cry. Owls Do Cry is first and foremost an outstanding piece of writing. Every sentence seems to picture the world in a way it's never been pictured before. Its narrative is semi-autobiographical, so much so that it was greeted with displeasure in the town where Frame had grown up. It tells the story of the Withers family, four children, Francie, Toby, Daphne and Chicks, and their parents, Bob and Amy, all of whose lives are blighted by poverty and misfortune. Francie dies in an accident just after she leaves school. Toby is an epileptic and his frequent fits have led to him being regarded as peculiar. Daphne has a complete mental breakdown and is hospitalised, while Chicks, the youngest child, marries a sales executive and tries desperately, very, very desperately, to live a normal, middle-class life. One way of reading this novel is as a lament on human separateness. The world is both magical and poetic, but the demands of everyday life prevent us from seeing it. If you're an outsider, as all the Witherses are, you probably stand a better chance of perceiving it, but then society will adopt especially brutal measures to wrench it from you, as happens to Daphne. Or you'll be shunned like Toby, or you'll die like Francie, or you'll be progressively stifled like Chicks, a mother, and to a lesser extent, her father. Meanwhile, conventional success is all too often a living death. In other words, Owls Do Cry is a searing piece of social criticism. There's a sense, it says, in which the lives we're all living are insane, and Frame has no time for the sentimental cliché that the officially insane might somehow possess a set of alternative, deeper truths. No, if anything, they're doubly broken. Is there any way out? Frame's pessimism isn't sufficiently developed to say she thinks not. Her style isn't unambiguous enough, the Witherses aren't represented enough, nor is their time or locality. The best place to probe that question would probably be the novel's last three pages, which somehow manage to subvert everything that comes before, whilst leaving a reader with the overriding suspicion that they're ironic. This is a highly intelligent, perceptive novel. The modernist manner of writing can feel, in the hands of some authors, like an affectation. Frame, on the other hand, feels born to write that way. It's difficult to imagine Owls Do Cry succeeding on any other terms.